Now verses 25, and it came to pass when Rachel had borne Joseph that Jacob said unto Laban, send me away that I may go unto mine own place and to my country. Give me my wives, my children, for whom I have served thee, and let me go, for thou knowest my service, which I have done thee. Well, this is quite remarkable here, by the way, because we're going to see that this man, Laban, had really mistreated his son-in-law and his nephew, Jacob. And listen to Uncle Laban here. You see, he's not going to be through. You can be sure of that. Jacob wants to get away. And now Uncle Laban says in verse 27, and Laban said unto him, I pray thee, if I found favor in thine eyes, tarry, for I have learned by experience that the Lord hath blessed me for thy sake. Now, this is something quite interesting. This was something that you will recall that Abimelech, king of Gerar, found out when Isaac was in his midst. He was blessed because of his presence. And this is something now that Uncle Laban has discovered, that God is with Jacob and he's blessed him. And Uncle Laban said, now look, my boy, don't rush off. Don't leave me. Just hang around. And I've been blessed and I want to raise your wages. I'll pay you more. Listen to him in verse 28. And he said, appoint me thy wages and I'll give it. And I tell you, Jacob ought to know by now that any time Uncle Laban made a deal, that he was the one that came off the winner, and not the other fella. But Jacob's learned the lesson. Jacob wants to leave. Uncle Laban says, I'll pay you more. And now he said to him, thou knowest how I've served thee and how thy cattle was with me, for it was little which thou hadst before I came, and it's now increased unto a multitude. And the Lord hath blessed thee since my coming, and now when shall I provide for mine own house also? In other words, listen to Jacob. You talk about a man complaining. He's singing the blues. In other words, he's saying here, all I've got out of all of this service for you are two wives and two maids to the wives, and I've got a house full of boys. In fact, he's got 11 boys now. Now, what in the world is he going to do? How's he going to feed them? And he says, God blessed you and he prospered you, and I don't have anything. In other words, you're the one that's prospering and I'm not. And now Jacob says, and will you listen to him?